Hi guys, my name is Jorge again here from SIRS Electronics, and today I would like to explain to you guys how an LED works. Okay, so let me show you a very quick informational presentation that I made for you guys, okay? So first of all, let's talk about what is a 5050 RGBW LED. 5050 stands for the size, which is 5x5 millimeters, and the RGBW means that you're gonna have four LEDs in one single enclosure. You're gonna have your RGB LEDs, and then you're gonna have your white LED. And this is a surface mount device, which is a very small electronic chip that you can also put in a PCB. So what is an LED? LED stands for light-emitting diode, okay? As you can see, an LED has an anode and a cathode, which are the positive and negative connections. Okay, you also have an epoxy lens that protects the LED and projects the light. So what is a diode? A diode is basically an electronic device that allows the current to only flow in one direction from the anode to the cathode and is blocked on the opposite direction. So if you try to go from the cathode to the anode, in other words, negative to positive, the current is not going to flow. So what else should we know about LEDs? Well, we have something that we call the phosphor principle. And in the phosphor principle, the ellipse, the voltage drop on the phosphor when the current passes through the anode to the cathode, okay? It leaves approximately about 2.7 volts voltage drop for a red LED and about 3.7 volts for a green LED. Also, the voltage drop in the LED phosphors creates some percentage as light and another percentage as heat. So the percentage that is made by light is also 10 times more efficient than the incandescent light invented by Thomas Edison over 130 years ago. Now, the phosphor is used by us in SIRS Electronics. It gives you the best efficiency possible. It's about 120 lumens per watt. So with this, we can share more energy as light rather than using cheaper and more popular phosphors available. If we use LEDs, we need to choose the most efficient phosphor in the market. Otherwise, we're using a phosphor similar to the incandescent one by Thomas Edison. Okay, guys, well, I hope you learned from this video and you liked it. If you have any other questions, make sure you comment down below. Remember to like and subscribe to our channel, and thank you for watching.